Okay, so with the new Gamma patch that just came out, I decided to make a new install of my game to start things fresh. And because apparently some of you cannot read, let's go over all the steps together. I've seen a lot of angry comments from people saying that they're having issues making the game work. And I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to be honest with you, but 95% of you having issues is because you are not following the steps correctly. That's it. I know some people are gonna get mad at me for saying this, but after installing the mod probably 20 times across all versions, it almost always boils down to you not following the steps correctly. And for the tiny amount of people who are doing everything right and actually have a real problem, you will most likely find someone with the same issue and how to solve it in the support and installation problems sections on the Discord. And yes, I do not like Discord either. I do not care for Discord. I'm an old and grumpy fart too. But I understand that when you have a mod this big with so many people playing it and the need to keep everything updated on a regular basis, well, Discord is actually a decent tool to do that. And that's why people are using it. So yeah, just get over it. I'm not done ranting yet, but let's get started. I still love you guys, don't worry. So first, you're gonna make sure that you have these dependencies installed, the C++, DirectX runtime and net framework files. I'm gonna leave the links in the video description, but you can find them on the Discord. And don't go, "Eh, I should have them, it's fine." No, go check. Actually, you know what? Install them anyways, it's not gonna hurt. When it's done, go to the install section on the Discord to get the other files. The links get updated regularly, so I'm not gonna put them in the video description. So you should have 4 files before we get started. Stalker anomaly and the anomaly update that you got on the moddb page, and the gamma rc3 and the downloads archive that you got on the Discord. The downloads archive is not mandatory, but to keep things simple, let's grab it too. Next, you're gonna create 2 folders on the root of your drive, one for anomaly and one for gamma, on the root of the drive, not anywhere else. For me, in this example, it's gonna be on my C drive. Do not put them in a folder, do not use special characters in the name. 2 folders on the root of your drive. That's it. Then we're gonna go to Windows Security, Virus and Threat Protection, Manage Settings, and in Exclusions, Add or Remove Exclusions. And here we're gonna add the 2 folders you just created. Back in the settings, we are gonna turn off real-time protection too. When you're done installing everything, turn it back on. It's just temporary, so it doesn't mess with the installation. I don't have an antivirus, but if you have one, you should turn it off too. And if you're not comfortable doing this, if you don't trust the dev team or think that one day they could get compromised, that's perfectly fine. Just don't play the mod. There's thousands of other things for you to play out there. I told you my ranting wasn't done. Anyways, with all of this done, we're gonna extract anomaly first in the anomaly folder you created using 7-zip. Not WinRAR, 7-zip. And we're doing it through the menu by pointing to your anomaly folder. When it's done, we're gonna extract the anomaly update in the same folder. I'm someone who likes to drag and drop to extract, but again, they tell you to do it through the menu. Let's all follow basic instructions correctly because it's not that hard. And let's point again to our anomaly install folder and extract everything the right way. Here, you should have a prompt to replace some files. Say yes to all. If you don't have the prompt, congratulations, you fucked up already. Just start over. Then we're gonna launch anomaly one time. Don't miss it, this is a very important step. And when you get to the main menu, you can leave. Now it's time to extract the gamma archive in the gamma folder you created. Not the anomaly folder, the gamma folder. And same thing for the downloads archive, right in the gamma folder. And no drag and dropping, I'm watching you. Just do it correctly, through the menu. Okay, stay with me, you're doing very good, we're almost done. we're gonna go to our gamma folder, then grok modpack installer, and launch the gamma launcher as administrator. Then click the first install initialization button. An error will pop up. This is normal, just click OK. In the window that pops up, choose browse instance, then go pick your anomaly folder. Not the gamma folder, the anomaly folder. And don't open the folder, just select it and proceed. Mod organizer will open, it will be empty, you can close it. Now in the gamma launcher, make sure that the four boxes are ticked and just click install update. The launcher will download and install all the mods automatically. It's gonna take a while, especially someone like me with a terrible internet connection. This will take 5 or 6 hours. Just press Windows key plus tab to open a new desktop and go do whatever you want during the installation so you don't mess with it. Go watch my weapons video, for example. The launcher will tell you when the install is finished, and congrats, you're done! Just press play and you can start the game. Don't forget to turn back your antivirus and everything, and that's pretty much it. One of the only issues I've been having regularly is with the gamma large files for some reason. If we check the installation console, you can see there's some funky stuff happening with my large files data. If you have the same issue as me, and only if you have this issue, obviously, the rest of you are probably playing already, and that's good, we are going to download the gamma large file separately. You will find the link in the video description. When the file is downloaded, we are gonna go to our gamma folder, downloads, find the old gamma large files, delete it, and replace it by the new one we just downloaded. Then you go back to the launcher, start as administrator again, uncheck the force git and update large files option, and start the install again. Let the installer do its magic, it should only take a few minutes, and here we go. No errors, everything's good, we can start playing. One quick word concerning updates. When you have your game installed and running properly, do not update blindly just because you checked the launcher and it tells you there's an update available. Basically when the text is orange and telling you updates available. Go to the Discord, check the announcement. You will see there if it's just a small hotfix or if it's a big patch, and depending on which one it is, go to the how to update section and you will find the steps to follow accordingly. Basically, if it's a hotfix, you uncheck everything and update, and if it's a big patch, you leave everything on, but go check before. And every time you update your game, you will lose your settings. They will go back to default. To avoid this, you need to go backup your user file that you can find in the anomaly folder in app data. Backup this file and just put it back after the update. That's all your keybinds, graphical settings, all the basic stuff. For all the rest, all the mod options, to save your settings, go to Mod Organizer, look for the MCM values. And then you're gonna rename this to whatever you want. And after the update, you will have the new default one and the one you just renamed. You untick the default one and you tick the one you renamed, and you will have all your settings back. That's it pretty much. There's nothing complicated as long as you follow the steps correctly. And again, if you have a real issue after doing everything correctly, go to the Discord, go to the support channel. People here are gonna be happy to help you, but they're gonna get pissed if they realize that you skipped some steps. So please just follow the baguette steps. Thank you. Love you guys. See you in the next one.